Did you know you could change the vehicle icon in Google Maps? Here's how. Once you've started your navigation in Google Maps, just tap on the blue arrow and choose your vehicle icon. I think I'm feeling mellow yellow today. Want even more Google Maps goodness? You're in luck, because these are the best hidden Google Maps features you should know. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and enough Google content that we could probably navigate the world over. Let's jump back into these hidden Google Maps tips and tricks. This next Google Maps feature is something I use all the time. You can quickly save labels to easily navigate to your favorite places. There are actually a couple of ways to do this, but let's say you type in your work address and you want to save this as your place of work. Tap on label, then we'll type in work. You can do this for any address and any label you want. Tap done, and now when you're ready to navigate to work, you can just type in work or tap on the option that comes up under your search bar. Google Maps will actually automatically save your most used labels right up here for you. And by the way, this trick works both on mobile and desktop. Tip number three, did you know you can measure distance and area in Google Maps? Well, you can, and this is another one that works both on mobile and desktop. So first, in the app, let's say you're in Firenze and you want to know the distance from your hotel to the Duomo. All you have to do is drop a pin and then tap and hold on the dropped pin and then tap on measure distance. Now you can move the map around to drag the measurement tool to your spot, and you're gonna have the distance in the bottom left. You can also add a point in the bottom right if you wanna measure another spot along the way. So from desktop, it works nearly the same way, but this time you're gonna right click on your dropped pin and select measure distance. Then just click on the location and you've got it measured out for you in feet and meters, and you can just keep clicking to add to your path. Pretty neat, but as promised, you can also measure area. On desktop, we're gonna use our same measure distance trick, but this time we're gonna connect the dots, so to speak. So if I wanna know the general area of Boboli Gardens, I'll keep clicking to add measurement points around the entire Boboli perimeter. And now we can see the total area measured both in square footage and square meters. You could easily spend half a day wandering here, but be sure to check out Palazzo Pitti too. So while we're on an Italian adventure, let's say you have to get to a certain meeting point at a specific time so you don't miss your wine tour. Well, you can actually set a reminder to leave. So from mobile, with your directions all set, scroll down to the bottom and toggle on the option that will remind you to leave on time. Here, select either the time you want to depart at or the time you want to arrive by. Then just set reminder. You'll now get a reminder on when to leave that takes into account current traffic conditions. Next up, you can drag and drop to modify your route. On desktop, once you have the directions set, when you hover your mouse over any of the blue dots, you're gonna have an option to drag to change the route. So you can simply click and drag to the route you want and drop. If you wanna undo what you just did, just double click on the route. All right, I think we're on maps tip number six, and this one is to quickly save a location for easy access. This is similar to what we did with labels. When you've searched for location, simply click on save. Here you can choose how you want to save the location, like your favorites or somewhere you want to go, or you could add it to a new list. You can easily access any of your saved locations by clicking on that hamburger menu and then your places. Here you'll have all your lists, and you'll notice you've also got your labels here too, which we learned how to save earlier. By the way, this works on mobile as well. You'll just swipe up from the location information and tap on save at the bottom. All right, did you know you can also see inside buildings on Google Maps? Well, some buildings at least. For this example, we are leaving Italy, so ciao, Italia. I find this trick works well with malls, so let's search for the Mall of America. And as we zoom in, we can start to see a lot of the stores inside the mall. But you may also notice on the right-hand side, we've got numbers. These are actually floor numbers, believe it or not. So you can click to see what stores are on what floors. I mean, come on, I'd say pretty neat, but then I would just be saying that all the time, and I'll spare you. But before we jump back into Google Maps tip number 8, if you're liking this video so far, please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for really more content just like this. And now back to the list. You are probably familiar with Street View, but did you know you can get a complete Street View history? Well, you can. This is so cool. And yes, we are once again back in Italy. So from desktop, you're gonna click on the little yellow person icon in the bottom right. Every street that turns blue means that street has Street View available. So I'm gonna zoom in here a little bit, but since we have the Street View icon selected, you can just click on any of the blue lines where you'd like to get that street level view. Now in the top left, you're gonna have some information on when this Street View image was captured. If you click on that where that little down facing arrow with the clock is, suddenly you're gonna have a history of that Street View that you can scroll through to see how times have changed. And if you click on any of those past images, you're gonna be able to see it in full screen. Time travel without ever leaving your seat. Number 9 on the list is one I have touted many times before, but it is an absolute must for travel, and that is to download maps for offline use. There are a few ways to do this from mobile, but let's stay in Florence for this first example. You're gonna have an option right in the card here to download the map of Florence. By the way, I'm showing you this on iOS, but you can do this on Android too. For Android, you're just gonna tap on the three-dot menu icon near the top right, and then tap to download the map. Either way, it's gonna tell you how much space it'll take to download the map, and you can just tap on download. And if you want a full tutorial on how to download maps for offline use or how offline maps actually work, I've got that video listed for you in the description below. And last but certainly not least is to send directions to your phone. This is so helpful when you're looking up something on desktop and want to just quickly send that right to your mobile device. So once you've pulled up your directions on desktop, just click on Send Directions to Phone on the left-hand panel. Every device that you're signed into in Google Maps should appear here for you. You're also gonna have the option to email the directions to yourself or text them to yourself. But whatever you wanna do, you're just gonna click on that option and the directions are instantly sent via that method. If you want even more Google Maps tips and tricks, well, you're in luck because I have linked to a whole bunch of Google Maps tips and tricks in the description below. And if you still can't get enough, well, bless you, my sweet baby angel. Just let me know in the comments below. And guess what? I'll make even more Google Maps tips videos just for you. So what do you think of these hidden Google Maps features? What are your favorites? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Maps content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.